Okay, so in this problem, we're going to go ahead and have our little ramp, object on a ramp, some mass. We're going to push it up the ramp. So our first step always should be to go ahead and draw our FBDs. So first of all, what direction is my applied force? Up the ramp, right? We just set it, so let's apply our force up the ramp. We'll call it FA. Any other forces acting on the mass? Friction. What direction is friction? Is it down the ramp or up the ramp?
Down the ramp.
Down the ramp. And why is it down the ramp? Okay, it's opposite of the motion. So if I told you that it's going up the ramp, then friction would be down the ramp. Now if it's this, and the motion is down the ramp, then friction would oppose that, and it would be up the ramp. Anything else? Okay, gravity. What direction is gravity?
Straight down.
And anything else? Okay, normal force perpendicular. All right, think it might be a good idea to rotate the axis again?
Yep.
Yes, definitely in this problem you can see, all right, right now there's 1, 2, 3 out of alignment. But if I rotate, there's only one out of alignment. And the one that is out is gravity. And once you learn how to do these, you fix gravity the same way every single time. And so all you have to do is learn how to fix it once, and then you're good to go for all these types of incline problems. Okay, so I'm not going to do the derivation of how to fix it. Hopefully at this point you saw from the last one that we just did. So we have some of gravity pulling down the ramp. Right? We call that FGX. And some of gravity is holding it on the surface. We call that FGY. Remember, here's your triangle down onto the surface, down the ramp. And what was FGX? Here's our angle theta, right? Our FGX is right here. Are we going to use sine or cosine?
Sine,
right. So this would be mg sine. The one holding us on the ramp is right here, fgy. That's our adjacent side. Do we use sine or cosine? Cosine. Be careful, the problems we just did, like the warm-up problem, remember the x's were always cosine and the y's were always sine. Notice what's happening here. The x is sine and the y is cosine. So it gets really easy to start mixing them up. If you can visualize your triangle, you'll never mix them up. Just know what the triangle is that you're looking for. Adjacent is cosine, opposite is sine. Okay, let's just fill in the rest. So this was our normal that we had before. This was our applied. And then we have friction coming this way. So I just filled in the ones that we already knew. Yep.
So the small rock to the right, that's not our official FBD?
Right. The official one would be before I started fixing.
Okay.
This is kind of our fixed one, our pure XY, like our XY free body. All right, so that's the hard part, is getting to this. Once you get to this, then it's just a matter of adding and subtracting forces, right? So we're going to go ahead and sum up our x's. So you just look here. Now in this, you kind of have a choice what you're going to call positive or negative. Honestly, it doesn't really matter. You could call the direction of motion positive, or you could just use our normal, to the right is positive, to the left is negative. Either way is okay. It's just going to give you a different acceleration. In one case, down the ramp would be positive, and up the ramp would be negative. Me personally, I typically use the direction of motion as my positive direction, so I'm going to show you it that way. But again, it doesn't matter how you, whichever one you choose. So since it's going up the ramp, I'm going to say that's the positive direction. So in that which case, FA would be positive. The negative direction would be our friction. I also like friction to oppose, if possible, the motion to make it negative. And FGX equals MA. Okay, same thing on the Y side. Let's just expand it. Notice what happens. So again, you have the normal equals FGY. And you can kind of skip some of these steps. This is MG cosine. That was what we got before. Hopefully you see that, that they're the same. This is balanced out with their MG cosine, right? Same thing here. So FA, let's just start substituting. What's our equation for friction? Mu times FN. And FGX is right here. And then we'll go ahead and substitute for the normal force, right? So I'm substituting this into here. I guess we'll go one more step, because I asked you to solve for A. Can we cancel the masses again? No. Okay, be careful. A big mistake I'll see is canceling the masses. Why can we not cancel the masses? Because it's not in all the terms, right? FA does not have M in it, so you can't just cancel the M's that you want to cancel. So the final solution would look like this, FA minus mu mg cos minus mg sine divided by m. Okay, again, don't try to memorize these, okay? It's just going to be, it's going to confuse you. In fact, if I gave you this equation and this equation on the test, you probably wouldn't know which one goes with which, right? And if I gave you 10 more that look almost identical, you definitely would not know.